Welcome to HeKate's Crossing. Right, let's find my glasses as we begin this journey. Right, found them. Right, I think you've seen what I drew yesterday, the two of vessels, with the Native American tarot, as you can see that I'm using. Now, two of vessels talks about unity. Now, I wrote yesterday, unity is going into silence and spirit and body union through which all spirituality flows, a goal towards commanding with all things nature, recognized by the intellect through the senses, through emotions and impressions. Unity is the law of nature. And so I went through and had a look at what they wrote in the book as well. This is part of it. The essence of union is an emotional flow, the new beginning of new feelings and a new life. Inherent is this gift of emotional healing. Reverse, self-centered, unloving, hurtful, and even sadistic emotions. Abusive rather than loving behavior. The catchphrase, joining together, physically, marriage ceremonies or signing contracts, mentally, business partnerships, agreements made for mutual gain, emotionally, emotional ties, and spiritually, union with spirit, the divine oneness. Now, for the Ten of Shields from the book, successful accumulations, tobacco. It was tobacco, not maize, and that I thought, or corn. Tobacco mixed with other herbs for ceremony, medicine, as a poultice, prevents gangrene, fosters quick healing, regulates moon cycles, eases fever and flu. If it blows the smoke into the air, relieves the earache, chewed for swelling of insect bites. The essence of harvest is new methods. A change of viewpoint can bring knowledge, wisdom, and reward. However, a little learning can be a dangerous thing. Reverse, speculation without the benefit of proper research can lead to cash flow problems, catchphrase harvest, physically unexpected financial gain, mentally the capacity for the process of and the rewards of learning something new, emotionally is the other side of depression and happiness, spiritually harvest of understanding within the momentum that takes us from knowledge to wisdom. Now I did write my own notes when I first saw the cards, as you would have seen yesterday. I talked about my thoughts were that the two of vessels was about union, relationship, any type of relationship, connection between two souls, emotional connection. Sun and moon talks about opposites, duality and polarity. The teepee or the tent in the background was talking about the home. Tree was about shadow, horse, movement, power and strength. The man and woman could be two people connecting, communicating, touch and intimacy. Ten of Shields talks about harvesting, opportunity coming, bringing in, completing, cutting, gaining, cutting or removing and gaining. Man cutting away the herb and collecting, that's important. The red cloth around the waist may talk about grounding, vitality, energy, passion and anger. So, looking at these two cards, I've sort of really reflected on what they could mean. A unity within the wholeness, with self and others, harvesting the relationship, nurturing it, and bringing it into fruition. So, I feel like, for me, that I am grateful for the relationships that have been brought into my life, no matter what those relationships were. So I feel like really I am grateful for the relationships, okay, that have been harvested throughout my journey. Now, I'm even talking about those difficult relationships, those relationships that are challenging. I'm grateful for the lessons learned. I'm grateful for the challenges. It's made me stronger in who I am today. It's allowed me to grow and develop. So it's all relationships that have been brought into my life, that have been harvested, that have been nurtured, that have been grabbed, that have been brought into my life for some reason. They're all of value and they're all really, really important relationships. So I think that's a really important aspect to sort of think about. I'm grateful for all the relationships that have been harvested throughout my journey, no matter what they are about, whether they were for a 5-minute acquaintance, whether that was something a bit more intimate for that moment. It doesn't matter. And I'm talking about past, I'm talking about my ex-husband, and I'm talking about relationships. Anyone that has come into my life, even some of those friendships that I thought were friends and have proved to be otherwise, to me they were all valuable acknowledgements in my journey. So I think that's really important to look at all the relationships that you've had during your cycle, during your life, during your path, and looking at those with acknowledgement, with gratitude, no matter how difficult they seemed at the time, they were so important, those relationships. I mean, even the abuse, the mental abuse that I had been through with the marriages that I went through, even those mentally abusive relationships were all of value to me at the time, because they taught me something really internally within myself. It helped me deal with situations from different aspects. And even some of those people who came into my life who were nasty or mean or just were not very pleasant, they still were of value to my journey. They still allowed me to grow and to develop within my life. So that to me is about acknowledging all those difficult, and you know, it's easy to acknowledge all the beautiful friendships that we make, really important, the relationships that we have, but it can be so much harder to actually acknowledge and embrace those real challenging relationships that we have within our journey. So this is something that I've sort of been thinking about in the last 24 hours and saying to myself, you know, how can I, you know, what relationships do I need to acknowledge that are just, not just the easy ones, but the truly difficult challenges, relationships that I've had to move through and process and really embrace with a sense of, not necessarily love, but a sense of trying to find a inner balance within myself. They may be opposite to easy, and they're opposite to making life really smooth and happy and joyful and full of passion. There are so many relationships that we bring into our life that are not just of balance and not just of smoothness and easiness and, you know, all those relationships we've had in the past. There cannot be any regrets. They can only be an acknowledgement and saying, yes, I went through that difficult time. I went through that abuse. I went through those arguments, those slamming doors, the breaking of things, the control. I went through all of those things to enable myself to move ahead with strength and with nourishment in a different way, that we may not expect. So that to me was the Two of Vessels and the Ten of Shields. So I think that to me is so important to acknowledge. So let us bring that together and let us reflect on what lies ahead for me in discovering what I'm grateful for. You know, what lies ahead for me in regards to, it's interesting how there seems to be two cards again have flown out, as you can see. Now we've got the Star and Medicine Wheel. So we've got two majors working together here, which is going to be quite interesting, because you see the Star here, we have this grandmother spider in the teachings. We have grandmother spider here, and she's weaving her web. We might find at times that webs break and they need to be redone. So I think that's quite an interesting combination when we look at that with the medicine wheel. So with the medicine wheel, we see cycles of time. We see cycles within our path, within our journey. So how do these two cards come together is going to be quite an interesting reflection when we think about it. So we're looking at the Star. And I've straight away, I just said about Grandmother Spider, as I know from the teachings, and the web being reconnected, remade, continued, even when it breaks. I mean, straight away, as my thoughts was about to allow my inner self to shine through. My inner self to shine through. So to allow my inner self to shine through, it is about reconnecting something when it breaks, or to continue to keep on trying, keep on creating. You know. So that's interesting. And then the medicine wheel, or the wheel of fortune, whatever you like to call this part, the medicine of medicine. I don't know, I spelled that wrong, but anyway, medicine wheel. Okay, so the medicine wheel, we talk, to me, when I look at this card, I'm talking about a cycle of time. So how do I connect this in the sense of great and acceptance of life's ups and downs? Is this destiny or fate? How do they combine? Or are they separate? So is it some interesting thoughts to think about when I'm thinking about how my inner self shines? You know, how have I done that? How, what have I achieved about reconnecting the, you know, that whole spider, the web connection sort of really speaks volumes to me. So I really need to sort of look up things a bit more and discover and think about how these cards actually combine. Now what I do want to read you, so let's just have a look at the Star. I just want to have a look at the Star. Go back to that in a minute. I just want to read you something. So let's have a look at this. I just want to read you something just to think about. Okay, Nilan Pizamok Ilantakik. Nilan Pizamok Ilantakik. We are the stars which sing. We sing with our light. We are the birds of fire. We fly across the heaven. Our light is a star. We make a road for spirits, a road for the great spirit. Traditional Algonquin poem sung as a lullaby to Magda Wet Gonzalez by his mother, Nora Wet. So quite interesting when you think about this. So in the Native American traditional medicine way, the grandparents were special, whether they were still alive or on another plane. The stars portray a special grandmother, Grandmother Spider, a totem in both classic and Native American traditions. To many people of Turtle Island, she was the creator or the creator's messenger, or at least a benefactress. Legends of her abound, from the Shawnee of the East Woodlands to the Hopi of the Southwest. Arachne the Spider was also the totem of Athena, the fate spinner in old Greek mythology. A famous icon shows Athena with her spider totem spinning fate's web from which one could foretell the fortune. So it's interesting. Talks about in Pinham stories, Earth Doctor, the creator, told Grandmother Spider to sew the sky to the earth with her webs. The water he sprayed from his mouth onto the sky web crystallized and became the stars. There's so many stories and so many myths about Grandmother Spider and how it all comes together. So it's very interesting to sort of read through this and sort of work out, you know, what does the card actually mean? So, with age comes wisdom, and from wisdom comes power. Only the wise can survive to a very old age in the universe that is so dangerous. So it'll be interesting to sort of read that. And here we've got the medicine wheel. You must remember, honey, luck is a lady, and she must be treated with respect. If you chase Dame Fortune, she will lead you down a road filled with illusion and absurdity. The only things you will win are sorrow, pain, and confusion. However, if you follow the spiral path, she blazes and goes quietly, accepting the gifts she freely gives. You will not only break even, but come out a winner. All your suffering will be rewarded. Your grandmother says this is a true of the spirit path as well, but that a woman's stuff, and I wouldn't know, but gambling is part of my life, and the great lady has always been good to me. So listen to your daddy and win. Elmer Weck to Magda. So interesting to sort of go back and have a look and see what's been written in the book. So now, for the next 24 hours, let me reflect on what the stars and the medicine wheel combine to ask of me. What, you know, what am I grateful for? What do I have gratitude for? So this leads me to a new path. Take care, blessed be. Thanks to Jen from Science to Soul Tarot with Jen for creating this fantastic gratitude tarot challenge. Absolutely brilliant. I'm really enjoying watching everybody's fantastic videos, their own reflections, their own thoughts, and just a fantastic challenge to do at this time, especially after listening to Jen from Jen's Balance Tarot with Simon from the Hermit's Cave and Elle from Wolf, Witch Meets Wolf, Wolf Meets Witch, the two of them with Shane to their channel, and of course Elle also with Simon and Becca with their Tarot Times, their channel. Anyway, with Jen, Simon and Elle today, their thought on the Wheel of the Year, the cards and things, and I thought that was quite interesting with June being, for me, the magician. So I'm looking at these cards and reflecting on how the magician, to me, is so part of this journey, of this grateful or this gratitude journey. It's really super interesting when you think about the connection of the magician in the thoughts on manifesting what you desire through using tools or using your skills and abilities, your talents, and putting them together to look beyond the illusion, look beyond the surface, look deep within. So I think that really sort of ties in really well with this gratitude challenge that I'm doing at the moment. So that's another tangent for me to reflect on at this time. Anyway, that's it from me today. Take care and blessed be. Don't forget to subscribe, like, ring the bell so you know when the next video will be up. Don't forget to check out the links on my channel, links down below. Take care.